Good morning, everyone. I'll be presenting a paper, Mammography Findings in Combination with Breast Ultrasonography Among Symptomatic Females. I'm from Vijay Medical College, Civil Hospital, Ahmedabad. Breast cancer is the most common cancer to occur in women, and it is the second leading cause of cancer death. Breast lumps are common occurrence in females all over the world. The incidence of breast cancer is rising worldwide, especially in the developing countries. Mammography has been widely adopted as a primary screening tool in breast cancer detection and assessment. However, screening in dense breast makes it difficult to detect lesions on screening. Virus classification density, which was proposed by ACR, which defines and classifies the density. The aim of the study is the utility of the whole breast ultrasound and digital mammography to detect the breast lesions and better characterization of lesions based on imaging characteristics. The objective of the study is to study the utility of digital mammography in determining sensitivity in screening of breast lump, determine utility of breast ultrasonography as an adjunct in detecting the lesions in breast, comparison of digital mammography with ultrasonography in screening of breast, characterization of the lesion according to ACR virus classification and histopathological correlation wherever applicable. In our study, the observational study of patients of 132 patients who underwent mammography and ultrasound in our department from March 2019 to December 2020. The mammography was done on the 3D mammography digital machine with the plate size of 11 by 14 inch, and two routine views were taken, the standard MLO view and the CCV. The ultrasonography was performed with a high frequency linear transducer with the frequency of 5 to 13 megahertz. The inclusion criteria, all female patients above 30 years of age coming for breast screening, the cases with pain, palpable lump, discharge, for the presence of characterization of the lesion. Exclusion criteria were female patients aging less than 30 years, post-operative and post-radiation cases, and male patients with breast-related complaints. In the discussion, the diagnostic mammography is used to evaluate women with abnormal findings such as breast mass or nipple discharge. With mammography, two views of the breast are usually obtained, the CC view and the MLO view. The MLO view will provide the greatest volume of the breast tissue, including the upper outer quadrant and the axillary trail. Compared to the MLO view, the CC view will provide the better visualization of the medial aspect of the breast and permits the greater breast compression. Specific mammography features which will suggest the diagnosis of a breast cancer are solid mass with or without striated features, asymmetric thickening of breast tissues, clustered microcalcifications, and these microcalcifications are especially important in the cancer detection in the young woman in whom they may be the only mammographic finding. In ultrasonography, in normal scan, normal retroareolar ducts may be seen as a thin, somnolucent branching structures. These are lacticiferous ducts, which measure 2 to 4.5 mm in diameter. The appearance of the breast parenchyma is variable sonographically, and it depends upon the composition of the fatty, the fibrous, and the glandular tissue. The fat in the breast is hypoechoic, the fibrous tissue is echogenic, and the glandular tissue is intermediate in echogenicity. The assessment of the ACR BI-RADS, the BI-RADS 1 is normal, the BI-RADS 2 is benign, the BI-RADS 3 is probably benign, the BI-RADS 4 is suspicious, the BI-RADS 5 is highly suggestive of malignancy, and the BI-RADS 6 is known biopsy proven malignancy. In our observation, the table 1, the frequency of tissue composition on mammography based upon the breast density on mammogram, A, B, C, and D type of density. The most common type of breast composition was type C, with the frequency being 66, about 50%. The age distribution in the study population, in which the age group were divided from 30 to 40, 41 to 50, 51 to 60, 61 to 70, and more than 71. The age distribution of study participants revealed the majority of females are in the age group of 41 to 50 years, with the frequency being 50, that is 37.87%. Followed by the age group 31 to 40 years, with the frequency being 38, that is 28.79%. The table 3, in which we graded the lesions according to the BI-RADS classification, in which the most common distribution came in the BI-RADS category 4, which is 38.63%. Then we carried out the diagnostic indices of mammography in differentiating the malignant and the benign lesions, in which the sensitivity came out to be 91.46%, the specificity 88.04%, the positive predictive value 92.86%, and the negative predictive value 87.04%. Then the diagnostic indices of ultrasonography differentiating the malignant and the benign lesions were seen, in which the sensitivity was 95.85%, specificity 91.67%, positive predictive value 95.86%, and negative predictive value 90.67%. So So, since the study was to look for the combined effects of the ultrasonography and the mammography, the agreement of findings was done with the combined imaging diagnosis and the histopathological diagnosis, and the diagnostic indices of the combined testing in differentiating the malignant and the benign lesions came out to be sensitivity 100%, specificity 97.48%, positive predictive value 98.19%, and negative predictive value of 99.41%. So mammography alone, when was done, has a lower sensitivity of around 75 to 90% in detecting the breast lesions in 10 breasts. In our study, combining the mammography and ultrasonography revealed greater sensitivity and specificity in detecting and differentiating malignant and benign lesions. These modalities show diagnostic indices that are statistically significant with higher sensitivity of 100% and specificity of 97.8% of the combined testing, and hence they helped in detection and characterization of lesions during the screening process. In this study, the lesions based on mammography due to the dense breast were subsequently detected on ultrasound with statistical significance. This proves that combined mammography and ultrasound helped in detecting and better characterizing breast pathologies. By combining mammography and ultrasonography, it is possible to detect even the small lesions and the few premalignant conditions like atypical ductal hyperplasia. In few conditions, possible sonographic negativity and mammograph positive calcifications can be found. Follow-up and targeted biopsy is helpful in such cases. The most common type of cancer on histopathology was found out to be invasive ductal carcinoma. The few cases from our study. This is the case of a 38-year-old female with a clinically palpable breast lump since 4 weeks. The mammogram shows high-density irregular shaped mass with the speculated margins and the edges and architectural distortion associated with the nipple retraction, and a few fine pleomorphic calcifications were seen. The lesion was in close proximity with the pectoralis major muscle, and axillary lymph node was also noted. Ultrasound image shows irregular shaped hypoechoic lesion with vascularity and surrounding echogenic parenchyma, and the infiltrating margins of the tumor was noted. In the case 2, 30-year-old female with a clinically palpable breast lump since 3 weeks of duration, the mammogram shows the high density large mass with a lobulated margin and perilesional halo, and few intralesional round calcifications were noted. The ultrasound of the image of the patient shows a large hypoechoic lesion with minimal internal vascularity and internal fluid caps were noted. This was given by the scatter 3 and histopathology also suggested the benign phyllodes tumor. So the third patient, a 40-year-old female with a hard, painless, palpable lump since 2 months duration, there was no history of fever. The mammographic image of the left breast shows high-density lesion with circumscribed marginal mammogram and no associated architectural distortion, nipple retraction, or skin changes were noted. No evidence of intradiscal calcification was noted. The ultrasound image of the patient shows the circumscribed hypoechoic lesion with posterior acoustic enhancement. It was given by the category 3 for possibility of fibroadenoma, and it came up with a giant fibroadenoma. This is the pathology. Everyone.